Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MySQL in a Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install MySQL in a Windows 10 operating system, first you need to download it. So for that, just simply click on your browser. And in here, just simply type MySQL, then enter. Now the first link that you will be getting is this www.mysql.com. Now just simply click on this MySQL. Yeah. And now as you can see, this MySQL installer 1.4 wizard has been rightly launched. And in here, they basically gave you some options to choose. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be just keep this all default. That is this developer default. And in here, they basically, going to be install this MySQL server, then MySQL shell, then MySQL root, then MySQL workbench, and then also this Visual Studio and MySQL connectors. So what I'll be doing is I'll be keep this all default and then just simply click on next. Yeah. And now under this check requirements is showing that this MySQL Visual Studio 1.2.3 requirement is not satisfied. And also this connector Python 8.0.3 also is not satisfied. So you can verify that by just simply click on it and then you can just click on check. And as you can see, this requirement is still failing. So what you need to do is you need to just simply click on next. And now just simply click on yes. And now as you can see, these are basically the products that are going to be installed. That is this MySQL server, then MySQL workbench, then MySQL shell, and then a MySQL router. So these are all MySQL products. And then they are also going to be install all connectors for ODBC, for C++, for Java, and then for Net. Now just and they are also going to be installed these documentations. This is going to be useful for to properly function your MySQL. Now just simply click on execute to to install, and it will start installing. And now as you can see, this MySQL server 8.0.23 is now currently installing. It will take some time to install all these products, so for which I will come back once when it gets done. Yeah. So welcome back, and now as you can see that this installation has been rightly completed. So now just simply click on next. And now as you can see, it's time for to configure your server. So for which this config type is a development computer. So I keep this all default, and it's using this TCP IP protocol. So, you know, keep this all checked, and then the support, and then the support number is 3306. So keep this all default, and X protocol port is 33060, and also this open Windows firewall ports for network access. So just simply check this, and now just simply click on next. Yeah, and now in here under this authentication method is, you know, basically I checked this use strong password encryption. So, you know, keep this all default and simply click on next. And here under this accounts and role, you need to give a password. So for which, just I will be simply giving a root as a password. Then repeat your password as root. The password strength is weak, but it's okay. You know, I will be using this in this computer only, so it doesn't matter that much. And here I will be also creating a new user. So for which, just simply click on this add user. And in here, give a username. So for which I'll be giving a Geeky Script, and for role I will keep this all default, that is this DB admin, and authentication is MySQL, and in here I will give password. So password I will give root, and I will also confirm that root, and now just simply click on OK. And now as you can see that your new user, that is the Geeky Script, has been rightly created. Now just simply click on next. And now under this Windows service, they basically, you know, check this configure MySQL server as Windows service, for which, you know, I'll be keeping this all default, and you know, I will also, you know, start this MySQL server as a system startup. So I'll also check this, and now just simply click on next. Yeah. And now as you can see under this apply configuration, these are basically the files that are going to be, you know, configured. So for which, you know, I'll be just simply clicking on execute to start executing. And as you can see that this executing has been rightly started. It will take a minute or two. So for which, you know, I'll be coming back once when it gets done. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can see that this configuration has been rightly completed. Now just simply click on finish. And now just simply click on next, and now just finish. And now under this connect to server, as you can see that this username root has been rightly given, and you need to give that password. So I have given root, so give the password root, and you can also check that. And now as you can see that this connection has been succeeded. Now just simply click on next. Yeah, and now you need to apply some configuration. So for which, you know, just simply click on execute. And now as you can see, it's now currently checking if there are any features installed that need to be configuration. So for which, you know, it's currently now running script. And now as you can see that this configuration has been rightly finished. And now just simply click on finish, and then next, and then just finish. And you know, it will start your MySQL cell, and then also it will open MySQL Workbench. And now as you can see, this MySQL Workbench has been rightly opened. And in here you can see that this connection has been created, that is root. So just double click on it. And now as you can see that this MySQL query editor has been rightly opened. And in here you can simply create a database. So for which, just simply type create database, give a database name. So for which I am giving a database name as a student, then semicolon. And now just simply, you know, select this and click on run button. And as you can see under this output section that this database has been rightly created. So now just simply, you know, use student, then enter, and again just select this and click on run button. So you are currently inside this database, and now we'll be creating a table. So for that, just simply type create table stud, and now I'll be giving this a column name. create table stored has been, you know, rightly created. And you know, you can simply, you know, check your table by just simply typing select star from stud, then semicolon, then just simply select it and then click on this run button. And now, as you can see that this student table, and now as you can see that this stud table has been rightly shown, that is the stud ID, first name and last name. So in this way, you install MySQL Workbench in your Windows 10 operating system. And also I have shown you how to create a database and also how to create a table. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. So thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you.